In theory, private life is insulated and shielded from social pressures, from the ambit of norms and laws, and even the strictures of public morality. Reality, though, is different. The encroachment of the public is inexorable and probably irreversible. The individual is forced to share, consent to, or merely obey a panoply of laws, norms, and regulations, not only in his or her relationships with others, but also when solitary. Failure to comply and to be seen to be conforming leads to dire consequences. In a morbid twist, public morality is now synonymous with social orthodoxy, political authority, and the exercise of police powers. The quiddity, remit, and attendant rights of the private sphere are now determined publicly by the state. In the modern world, privacy, the freedom to withhold or divulge information, and autonomy, the liberty to act in certain ways when not in public, are both illusory, in that their scope and essence are ever-shifting, reversible, and culture-dependent. They both are perceived as public concessions, not as the inalienable, though perhaps, as Judith Jarvis Thompson observes, derivative rights that they are.